Hi friends, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So I hope that you all are doing very well, and this is the January 4, 2021, and I hope that this year is going productive for you guys. So in order to make it more productive, I have brought this series of morning tales for today, in which I have a list of very interesting questions. So let's begin. But before that, the students who are coming for the first time, I would like them to subscribe and hit this bell notification. I think, guys, we have spoken this thing many a time, so ab to subscribe kar do yaar, because we also as mentors need motivation from you guys, that you guys are really liking our content. So if you are really liking it, then do hit the subscribe button and this notification bell as well. And this is the bonus for you guys. This Telegram group is for you only. You can join it and resolve your queries there. So do ask your questions. If you have any questions related to your career, related to the courses, related to any kind of examination, then do feel free to connect us on this channel. So the link is in description below. Now we are on our first question. So which state has announced to set up India's first ethanol plant under the public-private partnership model? So guys, this is just an announcement right now made by a state from the options. So which state it is? First is Gujarat, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, Kerala, Arunachal Pradesh. So out of these five options, the right answer is option B, Chhattisgarh. So Chhattisgarh state has announced to create or establish India's first ethanol plant. So this is under the public-private partnership. Guys, can you tell me that where is India's first ethanol refinery going to be established? So this question has been taken by me some days back, and I would like to hear it from my students how much they remember from the questions that I asked. So do tell me in the comment section below that where is India's first ethanol refinery is going to be established. Now our second question is, recently, Indian Oil Corporation has launched India's first remote mentoring and operation center for tracking of refinery gas turbines across all its refineries in Dash. So what is the exact place where India's first remote monitoring and operation center for tracking of refinery gas turbines has been launched? First of all, I would like to make it clear for you guys, this phrase does not mean very complex thing. It is very easy. Basically, a first of its kind monitoring center. A monitoring center has been established by the Indian Oil Corporation for tracking the gas turbine, refinery gas turbines. So that is the whole meaning of this thing, India's first remote monitoring and operating center. Now, where has it been established? So it is Hyderabad in Telangana, and do remember this thing that it has been established by Indian Oil Corporation. Now, which agency is the implementing agency of this center? So it is Bhel GE Gas Turbine Service Center. So this is the implementing agency of this remote mentoring and operating center. Basically, it will be establishing this center. Now, the technology that will be used in this center has been developed by three companies together. So what are these three companies? It is, first is Bhel, which is Bharat Heavy Electronics Limited. Second is GE, that is General Electric, and this is a US-based company. And third company is not any other company, it is the Indian Oil Corporation. So these three companies have together developed the technology that will be used in this remote monitoring and operating center that has been launched in Hyderabad. So do remember the points that I have told you here. And now my first question from you guys is the chief of Indian Oil Corporation. So do tell me in the comment section below. Next question is, with which IIT has Common Service Center Academy partnered to set up design and innovation in VLE's Indigenous Network Ecosystem Lab to help entrepreneurs, rural entrepreneurs? First of all, basically, this Common Services Center Academy has partnered with one of the IITs from the option. So the right answer here is IIT Delhi. So CSC Academy has partnered with IIT Delhi to establish this Divine Lab. And the full form of this Divine Lab is Design and Innovation in VLEs. Indigenous Network Ecosystem. VLE is Village Level Entrepreneurs. So, to help rural entrepreneurs. Now, what would be the function of this lab? This Divine Lab will engage the IIT Delhi students in research, and the students from the IIT Delhi will develop solutions or innovations to help the rural entrepreneurs, or we can say village level entrepreneurs. So that's all, that much is for this question. There is nothing additional to this question. But do remember the static facts related to this question that are coming up. So first fact that you should answer me in the comment section is that when was this entire Common Service Center network established by the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. So I hope that you know this thing that these CSEs operate under the Ministry of Electronics and Electronics and IT Technology. Now, the second fact related to this question is IIT Delhi's time. So I have asked two questions from you here, and I expect that you will answer your answer these questions in the comment section below. Which of the following is India's first indigenously designed and developed air droppable container? So this question is from the defense sector, and recently DRDO has developed the air droppable container. So what is the name of that container? It is option D, Sahayak NG. So Sahayak NG is the air droppable container that has been developed by two labs of DRDO in partnership with a private company. So what is the name of that private company? It is Avantel. So with this company, this DRDO has collaborated to develop this Sahayak NG, which is India's first indigenously developed air droppable container. Now the second fact related to this air droppable container that you should remember is that it is the advanced version of Sahayak MKI. So this is the air droppable container that was already in existence, and its advanced version is this, that is India's first indigenously designed and developed thing. Now apart from this, the other fact related to this container is that it can carry a heavy load of up to 50 kg. So this is a really minor fact related to this container, but I think that you should know about this thing. Therefore, do keep this in mind that it is the 50 kg capacity that it can carry and drop. SBI Yono has been ranked as the top new bank of India in 2020 in the BFSI Movers and Shakers 2020 report. Which of the following organizations released this report? So first of all, BFSI stands for Banking, Financial Services and Insurance. So this report has been recently released by Visiki. So Visiki's company has released this report. Now guys, this report has mentioned, or we can say ranked, top 10 neobanks of India, then we have top 10 NBFCs, then we have wallets. So which NBFC has been ranked as the top NBFC of India in its sector? So it is BHFL. And which top new bank is there in front of us? That is SBI Yono and wallet. So which wallet has been ranked as the top is Google Pay. So these are some of the facts related to this question that you should remember. Apart from this, this report is not very significant from the exam point of view. Therefore, the facts that I have told you are enough from the exam point of view if this question comes up in the exam. Now let's discuss our next question. Which of the following company has announced to acquire 32.6% stake in Air Asia India from Malaysian Air Asia Group BHB? So this is a very simple question of acquisition. We are not required to cram our minds with a lot of information here, because there is just a simple answer of this question. So guys, can you tell me the answer of this question? If you know this answer, then do mention it in the comment section below. It will help you in memorizing this question better. So for the people who don't know the answer, let me tell you the answer, that the right answer is Tata Sons. So Tata Sons has announced to acquire this stake in this Air Asia, and after this acquisition, the share of Tata Sons in Air Asia will grow up over 80%. So over 80%. Do remember this thing, that Tata Sons is going to acquire this much stake, and after this acquisition, the stake will increase to over 80%. So that much for this question, and here this session also ends. And I hope that you have enjoyed this session. Thank you so much for watching it. Do watch it for regularly for your examination preparation. Thank you so much.